Hey guys, this is what I'm doing. I'm Anime Intensity, and welcome back to my channel. So today I did something that I didn't expect to do this morning. This morning I woke up and I was like, you know what? Let's watch that anime documentary on Netflix. I had no plans to watch this thing at all because I was totally uninterested, and I could see why. After I watched it, I was like, why did I even waste 58 minutes of my life? But I was like, you know what? Let me watch this documentary so I could tell you guys my thoughts on it so that you, if you're wondering what it's about, at least you'll know kind of what you're missing if you haven't watched it already. So yeah. So I watched the Netflix documentary Enter the Anime. I keep wanting to call it Enter the Robot, and I'm like, it's not that, it's Enter the Anime. And this documentary is really trying to answer the question of what is anime? What is the meaning of anime? What is it? It's trying to address that question, and we have our main, like, narrator, and she's going to be basically walking around Japan and interviewing people, trying to discover the meaning of anime. I think her name is, like, Alex or something like that. But anyway, she is our narrator, and, we hear a lot of her dialogue, as well as, like, behind-the-scenes interviews of several anime creators that have worked on, let's see, Castlevania, Cannon Busters, Baki, Kengan Ashura, Rilakkuma Tokaru, Agretsuko, and Seven Seas. So I think we saw those seven anime mentioned in this documentary, and this documentary is only 58 minutes long. First off, I do think that this documentary would have been better if it was more of like an episodic kind of show. So instead of just one 58-minute series where everything just gets touched upon very, very quickly, I think that if it was broken up into episodes, it would have been way more effective, and we would have seen more details and more, you know, just, I don't know, soul maybe. I would like to see more of the interviews on these creators of those anime, like a full-length interview, a full-length behind the scenes, rather than just like 5 or 6 minutes per anime. And I felt like because of that, it was kind of rushed and switching back and forth from anime to this and blah, blah, blah. It just, I don't know. I felt like the vision for this documentary was good, you know, like trying to figure out like, what is anime? You know, what is it all about? But the way it was executed just was not good at all, which is very, very disappointing to say, unfortunately. So honestly, Enter the Anime, like I mentioned before, focuses around our narrator who wants to become an anime expert, but right now she's an anime newbie. And nothing against anime newbies, I think everyone has to start somewhere, but I think that for this documentary in particular, someone who is more into anime should have been chosen to do this documentary, because I felt like a lot of times our narrator, Alex, was very condescending in certain aspects. Like, a lot of times she would be like, oh, how can a country so clean and pristine and polite do this? And how can people wear this? And how could they do this? You know, like, how do these people that are like this and so polite and clean and whatever have a mind to create such things? Oh my god! You know, that's kind of how it felt. And I didn't quite like that. You shouldn't be putting down people's fashion sense. If they like, you know, gothic Lolita, steampunk Lolita, whatever, you know, the people that dress up in the 50s style, like, that's just what people, if people like that, just let them enjoy something. Don't be like, oh, WTF Japan, like, honestly. And I felt like whenever this person was on camera, whenever she was trying to find out the meaning of anime, it was always going back to how weird it is and how, you know, like, yeah, like, look at Castlevania. I was so interested because it was gory and bloody and action-packed. Like, wow, now I'm into anime. But it's like, then you see other things and you're like, oh, like, this is, you know, like, it's hard to explain, and I feel like it's something that you will definitely understand if you watch this documentary. But at times, I just felt like, you know, she should have came into this documentary with more of an open mind, you know? And yeah, there are definitely, like, different genres of anime and, you know, different styles of anime. And that's what makes it so cool, is that it's so diverse and so interesting. And at times, I just felt like she was just like, oh, well, this is weird. And, you know, like, anime is for just weird people, you know? Like, I didn't quite like the execution in that aspect. I felt like every time that she was on the screen, every time that she was narrating, I just felt so much more detached from this documentary. And that's bad, because she's definitely very prominent in this documentary. She's maybe mostly in it. So, you know, if you don't like her from the very first 5 minutes, you're not going to like her by the end of the documentary. That's for sure. Unfortunately, I'm sure she's a nice person, but the way this documentary was made just didn't really hit the mark. It didn't hit the mark. What I really did like was how we did see some behind the scenes for these anime productions. Seeing Adi Shankar, who worked on Castlevania, and talk about how he's a time traveler and all that stuff. Very interesting dude, gotta admit. So, you know, those things were interesting. Seeing LaShawn Thomas and Cannon Busters, that was interesting. And seeing the directors and producers of Baki, Seven Seeds, Rilakkumatto Kaoru, Agretsuko, all those anime that I mentioned earlier, seeing their directors and producers, that was interesting. Seeing behind the scenes is interesting. I just wish we would have gotten more moments of that. Those behind the scenes moments were what was so interesting to me. I like seeing the behind the scenes. I like seeing how, like for example, I think the producer of Kenran Ashura actually uses a phone to speak, and he's like, oh, I do it this way because I like this character from Judarara who talks through a cell phone. I was like, salty, yes. So I really liked some of these little interviews, and I also like seeing Yoko Takahashi, who is, you know, known for singing the Cruel Angel's Thesis, who was also there, has a cute, lovable personality, and also sang some of the songs. So that was interesting as well. So I felt like, honestly, those aspects of the documentary were interesting, and maybe this whole documentary would have been better if it was actually made into a series instead of one long documentary where everyone just kind of had to speed things up, you know? Have an actual episode dedicated to these people and really talk about anime, really talk about the making of anime, and don't just go on about talking about how, you know, you have this side of Japan and then this side of Japan, you know, like, anime is so much more than that. And I felt like they could have addressed this whole documentary completely differently, and they just didn't utilize things as they should have, unfortunately. And also, another thing about Enter the Anime is that it's not really addressing all of anime. She's trying to find out the meaning of anime, but she's only really touching upon like 7 or 8 anime. So, and they're all Netflix originals. So I didn't feel like there was too much variety, because there are so many other anime that are on Netflix that didn't make it into the documentary. And, you know, they could have done that and used more genres. The ones that they chose are like action-packed or a really cute Sanrio, you know, Agretsuko, Rilakkuma, stuff like that. And they didn't really venture into other genres. Use Violet Evergarden. Use, you know, Hisone Tomasudan. Use Kakegurui. Use different things to show that anime is so diverse. Not just use kind of similar style, not, you know, not in appearance, but like similar, you know, genre anime in your documentary, because you're not showing how diverse it is. You're not showing any of that. So I thought that they could have picked more diverse anime. They could have went more deeper, you know, in the past and talked about older anime as well, because anime has been existing for so long. What is the meaning of anime? Well, geez, let's talk about, you know, Baki from 2019. You know, honestly, they could have picked more variety of anime, you know, a different variety, and just more, so that we would have gotten a wider scope of anime as a whole, and they did not do that. I felt like they could have definitely expanded this documentary, but it just felt soulless and rushed, and I don't really think it achieved anything. I don't think she found out what is anime at all. I don't think so. I think she's still trying to figure it out. I don't think she became the anime master that she said she wanted to be. So, did she achieve her goal? No. And did I really like this documentary? Not really. It was really just kind of meh to me. And that's pretty disappointing. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Totally, totally appreciate it. If you watched this documentary, feel free to comment below and let me know your thoughts on Enter the Anime. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, or subscribe if you liked this video. And I will see you guys next time.